When done properly, integrating technology more deeply into your classroom can dramatically ease and enhance the learning experience. One of the easiest places to start is with your class documents. Incorporating your syllabi, notes, and handouts into docx keeps them accessible to students even after they've completed your course. With docx, your traditional course documents can even be integrated into your students' personal libraries. Your syllabus can become a portal for learning, rather than simply a schedule of readings and meetings. And if you want to change some of the dates or readings, editing your course materials only takes a few steps. You can create links to resources using Word's built-in hyperlinks tool, or you can enhance your documents using the personal book syntax, described in the help file. This allows you to turn simple references into live links, and integrates your documents into your library, just like the rest of your resources. Let's walk through this process step by step. Begin by creating your class document and saving it as a docx file. This is the only file format that the Personal Books tool can work with. So, if you prefer to work with word processing or page layout software other than Microsoft Word, make sure it gives you the option to save, download, or export your final document as docx. From here, you have two options for how to proceed. We'll begin with Word hyperlinks, since those will likely be most familiar. In the schedule for this theology course, students have been assigned a variety of readings, including question 3 from part 1 of the Summa. To make the reference to this reading a live link connected directly to that resource, copy the reading's location and paste it into your document. You can do this by opening the panel menu and choosing either URL or L4 next to copy location as. Both options will create a link to that question in the Summa, but where L4 links directly to your local docx installation, URL links to the docx web app and to your local installation. While you'll notice other formats in which to copy the link, these two are most effective for this process. Next, you'll need to highlight the surface text in your file and press Command-K on a Mac or Control-K on a PC to open the tool to insert your hyperlink. Paste the link you copied into the field next to Address and click OK. You can then repeat this process for all the other resource links in your document. Your other option makes use of the Personal Books syntax in docx. Open the docx help file to Personal Books syntax under Tools. In the Hyperlinks section, you'll notice that the syntax makes reference to two items, surface text and position. The surface text is what your students will see when they open the document in docx, and the position links to a particular location in a specific resource. To enhance your document using this syntax, you'll need to use the copy location process discussed above, but this time select Wiki. The Wiki option is particularly helpful for personal books, since it has already been formatted using the personal book syntax we just examined. All you need to do is copy the reading's location and paste it into your document. Notice that pasting this link into your document adds what looks like a bunch of gibberish. This gibberish is the surface text your students will see and the position reference pointing docx to an exact location in that resource. Whichever process you choose, do this for all of your assigned readings and save your document as a docx file. Next, open the Personal Books tool in the Utilities section of the Tools menu. Click Add Book and fill in whatever metadata you wish. You'll need to add a title and that may be sufficient. Then click Add File. Select your docx file and click Build Book. A dialog will track the progress of your personal book. The larger the document, the longer the process will take. If the dialog displays an error message with the words Build Failed, visit the Logos Help Center at support.logos.com or the forums at community.logos.com to get additional help. Notice that no gibberish appears in your final document, and all of your assigned readings link to specific locations within the assigned resources. If you notice errors you want to correct, or want to adjust things for the next time you offer the class, make the relevant changes to your docx file and save it. Then, go back to your personal book in the Personal Books tool and click Edit. Right-click your file and select Delete. Then repeat the process of adding the file and building the resource. In order for your students to benefit from the enhancements to your syllabus, you'll need to distribute it to them. You can do this through email, your school's learning management system, or through a Faith Life group. Creating, managing, and sharing with groups is explained in another video. Regardless of how you get it to them, your students will need to follow the same import process you used earlier to add the documents to their Logos libraries. You may want to walk them through the process in class, but you can also direct them to the support article on building personal books at the Logos Help Center. Encouraging this deep and interactive academic experience helps students get the most out of their learning and opens their eyes to the privilege and wonder of learning together.